Hey, what's up guys, Jeremy here. Robots are the main component of any RoboDK station. But oftentimes, to mimic the real behavior of your robotic process, you need to add some custom mechanisms. In module number 6, I'm going to show you how you can, starting from the 3D model, create it yourself in just a few clicks. We're going to see how you can create conveyors, linear rail, turntables, grippers, and many more. Let's get started. For this first video, I'm going to show you what using mechanisms in RoboDK can look like and where you can create those mechanisms. So here, let's start by opening basic mechanism module 6, and opening overview. Let's open the Game Boy assembly one. We already saw this station earlier in the training. I'm going to hide the cell and the window here. And let's start the main program. So here for this one, we have many mechanisms. I'm going to just reset that up real quick. So in this station, we have many mechanisms working together. So we have one conveyor here, another conveyor here. So that's two mechanisms. We have here one part feeder bringing in the screws. We have another part feeder here for the battery pack. We have another one here for the back plane. We have here, I'm going to slow down this simulation just a bit here. We have another one here to hold the part in place. So it's two finger gripper opening and closing. Another one here to pick the hole here and the whole assembly. And we have another one here just for screwing the screw or positioning the screw in place. So those are all mechanisms that we use here to improve the general look of our simulation. If I open here, let's say machine tending, we're using another mechanism here in this case, main program, to simply, in fact, we have a two finger gripper here to hold parts and not have to do empty travel, except for the first one. And we're using also here a linear axis to open up and open close the door. So this will be one of the subjects we will cover in one of the future in the video of this module here, how to create a door like this one, how to create a two finger gripper like this one. We will also see how to create a linear rail. So let's go here. If I go for linear rail, I will show you how you can create like here a linear rail where you can attach a robot on. So it can be used for milling or welding or other applications where reach is an issue. Here, let's start this program here. In this case here, the robot and the external axis are what we call synchronized. I won't show you how to synchronize external axis in this specific module. We will keep that for a later one, but at least you'll have the building blocks available for when the time comes. So you'll be able to pre-create your linear rail, attach the robot at the right spot using the measurement tool as I showed you in the last module. And here, let's increase the speed a bit. And then we'll be able to synchronize those and do some, what we call here, curve follow projects. So following a curve using the robot. So you can do that here. I did that on a single linear rail with the RDK acronym, but I can do it also on a, let's say, 3D setup with three linear rails. So I have one robot, one linear rail in this direction, one in this direction, and one up and down. So if I run the last program I have, can't remember which one is the right one. I did some test here, but you can see I'll follow the robot path, and I'm always kind of following the right height because I'm, like I said, following that curved profile which draw down the RDK letters. So that's another thing that I'll show you how to do later down the road. And if we just go for our last example, which represents what one of the exercises we'll do at the end here. If we go main program, we will learn how to do here the two finger gripper, linear rail, and how to use that to create a pick and place application where the robot is actively moving from one end to the other of this rail here. Cool. Before we get started with this, I want to show you a little something. So if you go on YouTube and you type down RoboDK, you will find our YouTube channel. So first of all, if you can subscribe, it would be awesome. But otherwise, if you go in videos, recently we released a bunch of video related to creating your own mechanisms. Some of those are go a bit more into details than what I will do here in the training. Also, it covers how to create robot arms. So you can create your own custom six axis robot, industrial robot, and six axis collaborative robot using RoboDK. I won't cover those here because most people won't do that. But if you ever have to do it, you have a two-part video here on how to do it. You have another part of video here on how to create six axis cobots. I would recommend you to watch the ones for the industrial robots first, as there's some information that I'm not repeating, as there's a lot of similarities. Here you have another video on how to prepare the 3D model for that process, which is also very important. And here, if you want to recolor your robot, you can do it using this one here. So anyway, there's a lot of very useful topic here or videos, so feel free to go watch them. It's very useful and complementary to what I'm showing you in this training here. If you want to create a mechanism in RoboDK, it's very simple. You go to Tools, or Utility, sorry, and you select Model, Mechanism, or Robot. By doing so, you will bring in this window here. This window will let you create a bunch of different types of robots, or mechanisms, in fact. So you can create a simple rotative axis. So this one will let you create something that turns, any mechanism that turns. So it can be a turntable, it can be as here, as we see in this example here, a jaw for a welding jaw, for spot welding. It can be a door that rotates, anything you can imagine. You can create two rotative axes, so that's oftentimes more specific to robotics. If you have a positioner with two-axis positioner, you can create it here. You have linear rail, so we'll use those for obviously linear rail, but we'll use those also for doors, we'll use those for conveyors, we'll use those for part feeder and many other use cases. I'm using those all the time, to be honest. You have two linear axes, same thing, but we have two type of motions. You have linear and rotative, so you have one option to rotate on top of the rail you already have. You have two finger gripper, so you can open and close your finger. So that's awesome. We'll have a video on that here. Three axis linear HBOT. So you can create a SCARA robot, another type of SCARA robot here. You can create six axis industrial robot, as I told you. You can create six axis cobot if you need, and you can create seven axis industrial robot. Here in this window, in this part of the window that will kind of change depending on what you're selecting, let's go for the linear rail, it's the easiest one. You will have the robot name here that you can enter. You will have a base shift and end vector shift. We'll touch on that real quick after, but I think that I will keep that for a more advanced, let's say, video on external axis, because those are a bit more complex. Here you have reference frame. So what is the reference frame you'll be using to create the external axis? And here you have both, in this case, both of the 3D models that will be used for your linear rail in this case. So what is the base of the portion of the mechanism that won't move? In this case, it will be the rail. And then what is joint one? In this case, it will be the carriage on top of the rail moving from left to right here. Build joint, we'll talk about that. Home, we'll talk about that. Minimum limit, maximum limit, you can obviously limit the travel of your rail or any axis you want. If you were to create a six axis robot, you would have the same parameters you can enter, but one set of parameters per joints you have. Okay, so that's pretty much everything for today's video. I hope you liked it. In the next one, we'll learn how to create linear axes. So those are very common in the field. It can be either a simple linear rail or range extender moving upward or anything like that. So hope to see you there. Have a great day, guys.